He's the former dictator who's been accused of treason. Just ahead of elections in Pakistan, General Pervez Musharraf is back, ignoring death threats from the Taliban and the imminent arrest threats from the PPP government. Musharraf landing in Karachi on Sunday afternoon, early on the day today, ending his self-imposed four-year-long exile. He was greeted by supporters of the All Pakistan Muslim League, the party that he had floated in exile in 2010. Now, Musharraf claims that he will stand in the general elections scheduled for 11th of May after the PPP government managed to complete a record term in power. Many analysts and insiders, however, claim that Musharraf's return is part of a deal orchestrated by the Saudi Arabia.
General retired Pervez Musharraf saab saath mein maujood hain aur Karachi ki jaane bada hai. Musharraf saab, how do you feel as aircraft is towards Pakistan? It's been a long time.
Yeah, bahut kuch apne tan wapas ja rahe hain. Bahut hi baat hai aur ek baaz nahi hai. Urdu meri itni achhi nahi hai. Ek nostalgic kisam ke jazbaat hai. Nationalism.
I can see tears in your eyes. You miss Pakistan.
Well, I do certainly miss Pakistan, but no, I don't have tears in my eyes. I do miss Pakistan. I love Pakistan.
और आपको लगता है कि ये जो जर्नी है कि कैरियर, बिकॉज आपके कैरियर में एयर क्राफ्ट की जर्नी जबकि ये 12 ये जर्नी आपकी लाइफ पॉजिटिव मोड लाइफ खुदा ना खासा कोई
इंशाल्लाह पॉजिटिव आएगी मुझे. Right. अब देखें जो आवाम जो चाहेगा वो
Headlines says Hamza Amir has been closely monitoring Pervez Musharraf's return and his homecoming back to Pakistan. Now joins us for a live update as well. Hamza, at this stage, you know, several hours has passed since Musharraf landed in Karachi. Just take us through, you know, the events which have been happening since then. Just what kind of a reception, in your opinion, has he been accorded?
Well, Pervez Musharraf, after coming back to Pakistan of 4 years self-imposed exile, was expecting a very warm welcome, as you know, as he had hopes to have attended a grand ceremony of people and, you know, a good number of people who would have been there to actually receive him. That did not happen. The people were there. That is a fact. It's not a small amount, but still, those were not good enough amount for him to be, you know, very happy about. And that is exactly what happened, because as soon as he reached the airport and his associates went out and saw the crowd, they actually decided against it that he should do a press conference. And that is why, you know, the press conference has been delayed and it has been shifted to Islamabad. Also, he was also scheduled to go to Mazar-e-Qaid and, you know, offer his prayers over there, because first he had to have a public gathering over there, which was refused. And now he is not even going over there because lack of security. There is not too much of security provided. So that is a sort of, you know, welcoming message that has been given by the government, that were actually not very happy on his return. At the same time, it is being said that, you know, now they are looking forward to much more coming out of Musharraf. Not only that, you know, he's back and, you know, going to start political activity. There is a lot that he has to answer first to the courts because he's charged on lots of counts.
The and people of Pakistan also closely witnessing, monitoring just how Pervez Musharraf's return, actually what it means for their country and their political future as well of their nation. Hamza, thanks very much for joining us. But he has a clear and present threat from the Pakistan Taliban. Even before he left for Pakistan, where he was greeted with a video of Taliban death squad, they warned him of dire consequences using, in fact, trained snipers and suicide bomb, in fact, suicide bombers as well. This video of what he can expect in his time in Pakistan.
Pervez Musharraf, you can see this death squad around me. We warn you to surrender yourself to us. Otherwise, we will hit you from where you would never reckon.
Well, opponents would like to warn many things. And the Taliban have been threatening me since after 9/11. For 12 years, so now also there is nothing new, so I have to go, and no risk, no gain. If I am not prepared to take risks, then why am I in politics? Why did I take this cause? I am not a confused thinker.